I will now take leaders' questions under Standing Order 27. I call Deputy Barry Cowan.
Thank you, Lascan Corda. Tánaiste, for some months now we've been pointing out that Irish families whose variable rate mortgages are paying are being charged 2% more than their European counterparts. On an average mortgage of 200,000, they're paying 4,000 more than someone living in France or Germany, for example. We've repeatedly called on your government and the Minister for Finance to get the banks to reduce these rates, but unfortunately to no avail. Other than AIB, who dropped their rates by 0.75%, no other bank has reduced their standard variable rate mortgage at all. The bank's response, to be quite honest, has been as inadequate as the government's. Minister Noonan's mantra is competition will fix it, and he has encouraged people to switch banks. Competition alone will not solve this ongoing crisis. Tánaiste, only 712 mortgage customers have switched their banks in 2015, and that is from a pool allegedly of 100,000. This in itself represents the weak competitive nature of the mortgage markets in Ireland and also illustrates that the government are suggesting a solution that they know is not working. Even the central bank accepts that there is a problem, while Minister Noonan has washed his hands of it. This is unfair and it's unjust on families, as I said, whom are paying 4,000 more per year than our European counterparts. Minister Noonan said that he wanted to wait and see if competition between the banks would decrease the rates. This wait and see approach is obviously not working, and I would contend that it will not work. It is even harder to stomach when people read that the Exchequer is enjoying unprecedented profitability with various windfalls while families are struggling to pay this €4,000 extra on top of their normal mortgage, as it should be. So, Tánaiste, do you think it's fair that banks are charging Irish customers up to 2% higher or €4,000 more per year on their variable standard mortgage rate? And do you agree with the central bank that this is a major problem? And can you honestly say that you agree with the wait-and-see approach that has been adopted by government for close on 12 months in relation to this issue?
Camogas, Tánaiste.
Well, what I think is unfair on Irish families is the fact that 5 years ago, yesterday, Fianna Fáil brought the Troika into Ireland and delivered the kind of desperate circumstances to many, many families right across the country. And I want to say to Deputy Cowan that it certainly has been a very long...
Sorry, members, we can't hear what's going on, please.
I want to say to Deputy Cowan...
Sorry, deputies.
I want to say to Deputy Cowan that I absolutely agree with him that it has been a very difficult, very long road for a lot of Irish families. Clearly those families who had the benefit, particularly people who bought in the year or two before Fianna Fáil's crash, generally had the benefit of trackers. And in terms of what happened in the banks, our banks, as we know, were basically broken by the failure of the former Taoiseach, both as Taoiseach and as Minister for Finance, to actually take any actions to safeguard Irish families. And the responsibility, I said, and I have... I went down to the bank to the banking inquiry in this house and I laid out what I said and what I did, and I gave very good advice to people. And let me say, it's in everybody's interest in this country that the banks, that we have banks which come back to working. Now, what I am disappointed at, I have to say, Deputy, is that You've spoken about people actually moving mortgages from one bank to another, but what you didn't address, and I don't know if you're familiar with this, is the fact that a lot of banks have offered customers deals for a number of years, which will actually improve the interest rate. Now, I don't know whether you're recommending people to actually look at those deals and to take those deals. Well, they're advertised, Deputy, by all of the banks around the country, particularly by the two larger banking institutions, where there are various deals which have been negotiated. And I'm sure at a constituency level, Deputy, you must have actually dealt with people who have been exploring those and seeking advice in relation to them. And in fact, for many people, it may not be the level of interest rate reduction that you're talking about, to the level that you're talking about. But in fact, many of the offerings are in fact offerings which will reduce people's overall payment required in relation to mortgage in relation to mortgage debt. I'm sure, Deputy, you must have seen this being advertised by a lot of the banks, and you must be familiar from your own constituency. Secondly, as you know, where people then have issues where they can't actually cope with the mortgage, we have a whole series of structures which we've established from the Insolvency Services of Ireland. But I actually assume that Deputy Cowan is talking about people who are actually paying their mortgage and they want a better deal on the interest rate. And I was certainly, his suggestion is that they switch the mortgage, and he's pointed out correctly that not many people have availed of mortgage switching. But I think it is important that people might seek better deals, which have been available from and are available from a number of banks in relation to changing terms for a period of years.
Thank you. Deputy Barry Cowan for a supplementary question.
Taoiseach, last May, you said, and I quote, banks would be extremely wise to consider their corporate responsibility in relation to people on variable rate mortgages. If the banks simply can't recognise that they have some obligations to the people of Ireland in the context of the bailout that they've enjoyed, there are other avenues to address this. So what are you saying? Are you informing the House, and by extension the Irish people here this morning, that some secret deal exists among some of the banks that are 2% less? Because let's face the facts. Last May when you said that, when you came out with your spin and empathy that you're very competent at, as we've seen in relation to rent and housing in recent weeks and the shadow boxing that we've seen associated with that. Bernard, if you don't mind, the people are there. You don't mind.
Sorry,
can I ask you?
Sorry, hear the deputy, please.
Do you still realise, are you still aware, or have you forgotten, or do you want to refer to the last government in every answer that you give in this chamber, that the rate is 2% over and above the European average? 2%. And I would remind you again that your former leader and your predecessor came into this House after a summit in June 2012, was it, and said that there was a game changer that he and the Taoiseach had achieved at a European summit, when there would be retrospective bank recapitalisation.
Thank you, Deputy.
You lost that last Christmas. You abandoned that trick. And you know what you moved on to? Oh, we're going to sell AIB. And you know what? It's going to realise a profit. because it's making money again. And why is it making money? Because it's charging 2% over and above the European average. That's why it's making money. And that's what you're standing over. And that's what you will
question,
be
please,
judged
Deputy.
On.
Question, Deputy.
And you can say all you like, but what you've answered in your response to me initially is more of the Tesco ad material that you're getting ready for
Thank
come
you.
The next
election.
Well, for a party who announced to the national media that actually you're not in the game at all and you're not even going to be involved in government, for a party who made that announcement, and it was a fitting announcement on the 5th anniversary of yourselves bringing the Troika into Ireland, that you said, and by the way, lads, we're taking our ball, we're taking our ball, and we're leaving the field. Sorry, that's what your spokesperson on your strategy said. We're taking our ball, we're taking the ball, lads, and we're leaving the field.
Sorry, we can't have this carry on. No, please, Deputy Kelleher.
Are you asking me to respect a
Deputy Kelleher, will you lower the tone?
Which claims please. To be a vital force in Irish politics and which says it's not going to be in government and it's not running to be in government. Sorry.
Please.
And
sorry, Deputy.
What we've done in government is we have nearly 2 million people back at work, including a lot of the people who actually entered into difficulties. But you don't want to hear it.
Well, please, there's no. If we lower the noise level, we might get some answers. Tarnisher, please. Well, order
You're
now, please.
You're obviously not
everybody.
Interested in any answers. You're just interested.
Please, Deputy.
Listen, Barry, anger isn't a policy. Anger isn't a policy. It's not a policy. It's not a policy, anger. And if you're interested, rather than trying to make some hay and cheap political capital out of people in mortgage difficulties, you would actually address the issue. Listen, you know, there's enough histrionics now from you at the moment to fill the Abbey Theatre any night. So just lay off. The colleague beside you said you're taking the ball and walking off the pitch. You're not going to be involved in government. So why are we to believe if you are gracious enough to give me the opportunity to address it.
Thank you.
Of course I'll address it.
Yeah.
No, eventually,
please.
After your history.
No, there is a time limit on all sides.
Will you lay off the histrionics?
Please.
Will you lay off the histrionics? Well, if you want an answer, then you just have to actually shut up for a while and listen to
the
answer.
Thank you. The time is the time. Thank you. Sorry, Connor, the time is concluded now, please. Thank you.